A lot of people, including me, are having motorised roller garage doors installed. Most of the receivers, those are the main control boxes, are not very smart at all. I'm going to show you how to turn a standard receiver into a smart one connected to Home Assistant. My garage door is controlled by a Somfy Rolixo RTS roller door system. It has a receiver bolted to the wall and plugged into the mains, and there's a wireless safety edge sensor at the bottom of the door, which also has a magnet so it knows whether or not the door is shut. It comes with these little remotes which work on 433 MHz, and I was previously using an RFX con to intercept the signal of one of these remotes and control it using Home Assistant. But I'm looking to start retiring that old wireless device, so thought I should look at controlling it more directly. Now, there are lots of smart garage door controllers out there, and you can buy them off the shelf. One of the more popular ones I've seen around is the Miros Smart Garage Door Opener. It works over Wi-Fi, has its own app, comes with a door contact sensor, and isn't badly priced really. But what most of these pre-made options all have in common is that they are all basically just a fancy momentary switch, so a relay that turns on and then off straight away, and that's something that is really easy to make using ESPHome. Let me show you in my garage how they work. I've turned off the power to my receiver and I've opened it up so as I can show you these two terminals here, which are numbered 10 and 11 on mine. Now, if you were to short those two terminals, then it sends a signal to the receiver that it wants to control the garage door. So it will control it in a sequence of open, stop, close, stop and repeat. All smart controllers that control non-smart garage door receivers will connect into these terminals, and your receiver will be different, but most certainly have these pins somewhere, so you need to check the manual. I've connected some bell wire to those terminals and run that into this little box here that I've put next to the receiver. The inside of this wall box is very simple. There's just two components. You've got the D1 mini here and you've got a relay here. The bell wire, which is this one here, is connected to the relay, and then the D1 mini is connected to the relay, and it's just powered by a USB cable. So with just those two components plus a case and some wires, you have yourself the start of a smart garage door controller. The best part about this is that I already had all of the parts needed to make this. Remember that speed control fan project from a previous video? Well, I just pulled the relay and microcontroller from that. Connecting it all together is quite simple. Note that I'm using pin D1 on the D1 mini to connect to the relay, and that's quite an important detail. Pin D1 doesn't push out any stray voltage on boot up like the other pins do. If you connect a relay to the other pins, then when you power on the microcontroller, it can send a pulse to the relay, which can cause your garage door to open unintentionally. You'll see we also have the outside of the relay connected to the NO or normally open pins. Now that you've physically put the project together, you're going to need to program it. This is an ESPHome video, so I'm of course going to show you the ESPHome configuration. It's really quite a simple configuration, I'll show you here. So apart from all of the usual standard configuration that you've got up at the top, there's only one entity right down here at the bottom. It's a switch entity that when turned on, it'll wait half a second and then turn itself off again. Install this configuration to your microcontroller and you should end up with an entity called switch.garageDoorRelaySwitch, like it's written here. You can test that relay out by turning it on and it should immediately turn itself off, and it should also control your garage door. But so far this is just a one-way thing. You can control it, but you have no way of knowing whether it is open or closed. It could have been opened manually, and when you send it the command to open, then it could be closing. To fix this piece of the puzzle, you need another component, a door contact sensor. I have an old SmartThings Zigbee multi-sensor on the opposite side of the garage door, right at the bottom. You could use any door contact sensor really. There are Wi-Fi ones, Z-Wave ones, or Zigbee ones. The choice is yours. You'll then need to join it all together using a special template cover entity in Home Assistant. Edit your configuration.yaml file. I'm going to assume you already know how to edit configuration files if you've made it this far. Paste in a template sensor like this one. You'll need to edit the contact sensor entity here and here and replace that with the entity ID of the actual contact sensor that you've installed on your garage door. The three actions here for open, close and stop all do exactly the same thing and just turn on the relay switch in the ESPHome device. Save this configuration and restart Home Assistant to apply it. Once you've restarted, you should have an entity called cover.garageDoor. I've added it to my dashboard here along with all of the other related entities. If I click on open, you should see that the garage door contact changes to open too. The cover entity's state is totally linked with the state of the contact sensor. So if the door is opened manually, then the cover's state in Home Assistant will also show as open. And there we have it, a homemade garage door controller. Now, if you didn't want to buy a wireless door contact sensor, then you could take the project a step further and use a cheap magnetic reed sensor wired directly into the microcontroller. You'd need to adjust the configuration, of course, in order to present that sensor as a contact sensor in Home Assistant. I'd already got the Zigbee sensor on the door, so didn't need to do that, but please do share if you decide to go down that route. Anyway, I'll put the configuration and wiring diagram up on my website, and the link to that will be down in the description. I hope you found this useful, and if you did, then please give it a like and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.